Hello, what's up? Gleb Alexandrov here. In this video, we're going to cover a fun way of merging and fusing the hard surface shapes like this in Blender without the third-party add-ons. That being said, it won't be mathematically pristine, but oh boy, it's quick. Ooh, let's try something. Smash that like if you're into hard surface or mechanical 3D. For movies, games, or your personal art, let's see our numbers. So, first I will create a cylinder from the Shift A menu, the default settings for it. Then, since I'm gonna use Eevee, I'll give it a material. Gray color, medium roughness for that one, just to give it some shine. And in addition to that, I will add some coating to it, increasing the weight, giving it a low roughness, shade auto smooth in the end. Then I'll press Ctrl R to subdivide it like that. We will need it for the fusion operation. R and X to tilt it like that on the X axis. Then I will scale it on the Y. Then Shift D to create one more cylinder and rotate it like that. And move it over there, so it intersects with the first one. I will scale it down like that, so it doesn't protrude too far. Something along these lines. A classic merging two cylinders situation, you know? Where two cylinders meet, I will probably add a few more subdivisions with the help of the Ctrl R shortcut. Just like that. Maybe here as well? Basically, where two surfaces meet, to give it some more geometry to play with. Currently, these meshes intersect. They aren't joined together, as they should. So we should probably start with adding the Boolean operation. It's gonna be union. Now let's just select this second cylinder. And now, upon applying the Boolean modifier, we should see that this should be a singular shape from now on. I will delete the Boolean object. Then we can check it in the solid shading mode with the X-ray enabled, for instance. So it's a singular shape indeed. I will also apply the auto smooth. Okay, it has left some edges marked as sharp. So I will probably select these ones. X-ray mode to make sure we got it all. And then Ctrl E to bring up the edges menu and clear sharp. So that's our base mesh. It hasn't been fused yet, but here we go. Of course, the easiest method would be to just slap the remesh modifier with the voxel style of remeshing on top of it and configure the voxel size, but, you know, it isn't ideal in many cases, and it generates a pretty chaotic geometry to play with. The sharp method could work arguably much better for the hard surface shapes. We will explore it in some other video, but for now, I will show you a slightly different method of approaching it. Slightly more destructive, but at the same time, pretty fresh and pretty fun. First of all, I'll activate the edge selection mode here, or by pressing 2 on the keyboard, and then I will hold Ctrl and just define these edges running around in a loop like that. Whoops. Not these. Yeah, we have to be extremely careful with this selection. We got it all, I think. Now I'm pressing Ctrl B to activate the bevel tool. I'm using the mouse wheel to adjust the number of segments. We don't need many. It looks horrendous right now, as you can tell. It's so crazy. But bear with me. Now we can press Ctrl plus or Ctrl minus to expand or contract the selection like that. I will expand it a little bit. Maybe something like that. And then I'll go vertex, smooth vertices. Or just search for it in the search menu. Look at that. Here we have the menu for adjusting the number of repetitions for that effect. And as we go higher, you can see how the geometry gets smoothed out and the intersection gets healed. At the same time, the object starts to lose its shape a little bit. So to compensate it a bit, I will go Alt-S to fatten it like that. It will create some bulging in the case like that, though. So it's probably not perfect by any means. So I'll Ctrl-Z it to where it was before. And I will go Ctrl-B again for bevel. I will give it just 3 segments. Then Ctrl-plus to expand the faces selection. and smooth vertices again. Maybe with slightly less repetitions. Something like that. Alt S to fatten it. And now we're talking. Look at that. It's pretty clean fusion, isn't it? Tab to enter the edit mode, and we can still grab these edge loops, left after beveling, then X and dissolve these edges. That is, if you want to optimize it a bit in terms of the polygonal density. Then, if the shape still needs some extra polishing, why not give it some smoothing in the sculpting mode? I know, it's often a taboo in hard surface modeling, sculpting. It's not super precise, but it does the job. Then feel free to add some beveling on top of it, and maybe some beveling on top of beveling to create that hard surface mechanical finish. I think it looks great. Even though this technique is pretty sloppy, it gets the job done. Then we still have this funky looking face loop over here, so you can double click to select it. Then expand the selection like that if you want it to be even smoother, and go smooth vertices again. This time cranking up the number of iterations considerably. That is, if you want to create this kind of transition. Since we use the EV material preview mode to preview our mesh, what we can do is actually increase the amount of coating and decrease its roughness. The extra glossiness will make it easier for us to debug any potential normal issues. To sum it up once again, that's how the method goes. First we create a mesh that we want to fuse with this original object. We make sure it's nicely subdivided and has enough geometry to work with. Then we unite it with the original shape using the Boolean union operation, upon which modifier is collapsed. As a next step, we define the selection between these two shapes. There are quicker ways to do it, but here I'll just do it manually, holding control. And then we bevel this intersection and give it just a few segments like that. Finally, we expand the selection a bit and smooth it out using the smooth vertices command. That gives us a quick and dirty lofting between the two parts of the mesh, which as a final step can be smoothed out in the sculpting mode alongside other things. Well, it's probably better to use plasticity for that rather than Blender, but as you can see, this method worked for us pretty well here, even though topology is far from being perfect. The rest is adding some decals to that, but we'll get to that eventually. Alright, thanks for watching! As you've probably sensed, we are brewing something in our creative stream labs with AED. We are always brewing something, so stay tuned. Feel free to subscribe to this channel and to our social media. That was me, Gleb Alexandrov, for creativeshrimp.com. Keep modeling, keep drinking coffee, and I will see you next time. Is that it? I think so.